All arounder, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 3 World War 1 mod. We are now continuing off of where we last left. Germans and Austrians are advancing deeper into Russia, as territory is also slightly gained by the Ottoman Empire, both in southern Russia and Egypt. We are at peace with France. But if we choose to, we can declare war. We've got spies in Russia. Oop, unrestricted submarine warfare. The British, with their overwhelming sea power, had established a naval blockade of Germany immediately on the outbreak of war in August 1914. And in early November 1914 declared it to be a war zone, with any ships entering the North Sea doing so at their own risk. The blockade was unusually restrictive in that every foodstuffs were considered contraband of war. The Germans regarded this as a blatant attempt to starve the German people into submission and wanted to retaliate in kind. And in fact, the severity of the British blockade did not go over well in America either. Germany could not possibly deal with British naval strength on an even basis, and the only possible way Germany could impose a blockade on Britain was through the U-boat. The German Chancellor, Theobald von Bethmann Hollweg, felt that such a submarine blockade based on shoot without warning would antagonize the United States and other neutrals. However, he was unable to hold back the pressure for taking such a step. And we gained Persian oil fields. I see what's going on. In the base game, like the vanilla, this is part of Persia right here. Or Iran. Iraq. Either way. And so, when they lose territory or gain it, that will keep flashing. So, yeah, that's happening. Germans are making slight progress here, but not really. We've got some technologies. And as for such, we just kind of sit back and enjoy the show for the most part. There really isn't much that's going on, apart from the fact, I mean, if they can capture St. Petersburg and the Crimean Peninsula, I will declare war on France. We've been embargoed by Greece. Keep sending in call to arms, which I could accept, but I'd be afraid that, because I've only got two armies, one army group, first and second army, both composed of five corps, so yeah, that's a thing. Tech is being completed. And see slow progress here on the Eastern Front. They can just get to St. Petersburg, I'll declare war. Because if we look at Russia now, in their current state, Russia is already close to 50%, and along with their national unity slowly being drained by my spies, with the capture of St. Petersburg, which for victory points is rated at 30, that will probably almost make them capitulate. If not, kudos to them, because they can hold on for a fairly long time. The Austrians are losing. How can you lose to Montenegro? Really? I mean, I understand it's AI, but I mean, come on. Montenegro was like 5 provinces. I can understand Serbia, because Serbia was, like, a full-fledged nation, had decent IC and stuff. Oh. Oh! And my game's going to freeze for a little bit, because it's going to transition. I did not expect that to happen so fast. German Empire enforced fall on Russia. Oh, wow. I hope my game didn't crash. Oh, there we go. So, let's pause this. Austria-Hungary enforced the same principle. Treaty of Brest-Litovsk. I hope I pronounced that right. Following the success of the October Revolution, the newly established Soviet government sought to withdraw Russia from the World War. On the 26th of October, 1917, Vladimir Lenin signed Decree on Peace, which was approved by the Second Congress of the Soviet of Workers, Soldiers, and Peasants Deputies. The decree called upon all the belligerent nations and their governments to start immediate negotiations for peace, and proposed an immediate withdrawal of Russia from the First World War. Soviet Union. Troops head home. After the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, most soldiers simply abandoned their post and went home. Tsar Nicholas abdicates from the USA. News of the Russian Tsar's abdication was welcome news in the United States, where the Russian absolute monarchy was almost held in such low esteem it was nearly as bad as that of Germany. With the Tsar gone, there was no reason left why the United States could not join the war, since they would not be seen any longer as supporting the Russian monarchy. So the United States joins the war, and I'll just do the call to arms. And I join the war. Now I could just focus on this front. And Austria-Hungary can also focus there in the Balkans, so I should actually extend the picture a little more. Oh, there goes Serbia. And interruption. Hold on 1 second. As we continue back, we have the USA occupation of Haiti. Anti-American violence in the country of Haiti is threatening U.S. business interests, especially considering the local German community controls most of the Haitian industries. We must act quickly to preserve our economic dominance over Haiti. The USA has now probably declared war on Haiti, and Austria-Hungary now is conquered on Montenegro. So the Balkans is secure for the most part. You've got Albania and Greece left, but I think Albania is kind of neutral. As for the most part, if this continues, the Ottoman Empire can relinquish more forces towards England, Austria-Hungary and Germany, and Italy, which is me, can relinquish a lot more forces to deal with France. And new technology. Industry. Yeah. Oh, lag. What's happening? Hold on. I don't know what was happening, but I've got to fix. So, fixing that, and what's this? Bridging and... Let's do... Casualty trickle back. And bridging. We got the Persian oil fields again. Soviet Union. Was declared Russian Civil War. The Russian Civil War, which broke out in 1918, shortly after the revolution, brought death and suffering to millions of people, regardless of their political orientation. The war was fought mainly between the Red Army, the Reds, consisting of the uprising majority led by the Bolsheviks minority, and the Whites, army officials and Cossacks, I'm not going to even attempt to pronounce that. And political groups ranging from the far right to the socialist revolutionaries who opposed the drastic restructuring championed by the Bolsheviks following the collapse of the provisional government to the Soviets. Under clear Bolshevik dominance, the Whites had backed from nations such as Great Britain, France, USA, and Japan, while the Reds supported internal and domestic support, which proved to be much more effective through the Allied nations, using external interference provided substantial military aid to the loosely knit anti-Bolshevik forces. They were ultimately defeated. And as we make slow progress through France, we make progress nonetheless. So I believe I've already got spies set up in France, and due to this slow progress, it's actually going to be a while before they declare, they surrender. So, yeah. Somehow Luxembourg is gaining a couple provinces, but that's mostly under France, but... details. If we gain more territory in the south, we can expose their southern flank and maybe swoop around. Kind of do like a reverse Schlieffen plan. I can never pronounce that. If you know what the Schlieffen plan was, it was the Germans' way of invading France by going through Luxembourg and Belgium and swooping around from the top coastal region and encircling Paris, creating a quick defeat. USA now has an event for the sinking of the Lusitania. The RMS Lusitania, a civilian ship carrying passengers between England and the United States, was sunk by a German submarine this morning. 123 Americans died. Neither the Germans nor the Americans learned that this ship was carrying weapons and supplies. The Congress of the United States is slowly drifting towards intervention. Great. Just what we need. But, yeah. Continuing on with the war, we are actually gaining slow amounts of territory here in the south. If we could somehow get this area and make the units here collapse, we might be able to encircle here. Oh. Huh. The United Kingdom is purchasing vessels. Interesting. So, yeah, for the most part, this is going to be a slow war. Kind of like in real time. But this will go by a lot faster and we'll probably be stuck in like 1920s and this war will still be going on. And as the month draws to an end, so shall the video. As always, if you like this video, leave a comment down below, see if I can improve any of my tactics and or attributes for your viewing capabilities. And this has been the All-Arounder, and I'll see you guys next time.